in 2002 he got put to jail for that. And now, last week, there was in the newspaper that he was died in the jail. So that's a good way. But the justice and the citizen, they have they turn the whole farm down. So you know, there's nobody who wants to live there. And in Groningen, it's not so that you that houses stay forever, but they broke it down, and now you got all green and nothing. But I think, you know, he lived here, and I think he was happy, and who knows what is lying here in this, you know, in this open fields. It is so big. So I got my spirit box and I think maybe I can search for him. Maybe he's here, his spirit is here. And yeah, you know, I want to talk with him. A fucking killer, you know. It's very bad that we had a monster in the town. So join me, okay? And it's 3 o'clock. I think he called it. I don't know. It's 3 o'clock. Okay, 1500 hours. I'm here at the place where Willem van Eyck lives, and where he killed a lot of women. Most of the women are prostitutes, but you know. When you become a prostitute, it's when you are really are in a shit. So don't judge the women because they do that. But I call up all the women who murdered by Willem van Eyck and give me some answers so you get justice for what is done to you, you know. And Willem, you are the monster from Groningen, and I hope you're rotten in hell. Okay.
Kick your ass.
Okay. Please, spirits, if there's spirits, please talk in the spirit box. I am here now. So you can tell me the story. Look, there's nothing here, nothing. Only poisoning stuff is growing here. And they broke down his house, and I think that's a good thing. Just let me see what's here. What is that? Wait a moment. I see a door. Whoa! I got a really heavy bag on my. Oh my god, what's that? I don't like dolls, but what the? What is this? Look! Okay. My spirit box is very strange. Look! Well, the moment I find these dolls, my battery is totally drained, so I need to refresh it. But look, just, oh, you know, there's a head, oh, I don't know what it is.
Look, this doll has very much hair. Maybe that's a couple? Why are they lying here? There's nobody around. What should I do? Well, you know, I hate dolls because I always think there's something in it. But hello, dolls. How are you? Look, this one. It's a very strange. This looks like real hair to me. Oh my god. It's old fashioned. It's really from the years. Oh, look this. This is a baby, I think, or a woman. I don't know. What's your name? My name is Mariam. I was here for an investigation on Willem. And now I have you. Oh my god. Can you tell me who you are? Look. Aww, so cute. Well, cute, I don't know. Their eyes are... they painted. Alright, but look. It looks like Tina Turner. Well, look. I see sheep. Okay. Is there anyone here? Please talk to me. Okay. I hear that. Talk more, please. I am Mariam. And I'm searching for spirits. So spirits, talk to me. If there are spirits in these dolls, let me know who you are. They have the same shoes, same hands, I think. Let's look, have they the same face? No, a little bit different. I don't know if I like this. I take them with me. And it's so quiet here. Spirits, talk to me. And in these fields, yeah. Okay. That was strange. But there, I think there is a lot of more bodies here around. But you know, they are building a lot of houses, new houses. Hello, talk to me. Sorry, girls. But I came here for Willem. Willem van Eyck. Are you here? Maybe it's a good sign that he's not here. Victims from Willem. You know, I put the dolls. I don't know what to do with it. But I put them in my scootmobile, take them home. I think that's the... Okay, talk. Buy my drinks. Don't drink my drink. Or at least let something. Don't drink my drink. Or don't drink at all. Okay. I think that hand is, well, We live in 2019. Yeah, so. Well, I don't know what to do with you. But you are brother, sister, or men, women, or women, some curly women and some butchy. I don't know. It doesn't matter. Maybe when they used at me, they talk to me. Talk to me, please. I don't go in the fields because, you know, I don't know where. Okay. Hello. I am Miriam. And I'm searching for the spirits of the victims from Willem van Eyck. I was a YouTuber a long time before, because then I can film the house. And now there is nothing from the house over. They destroyed it totally. And you know, you can see the sheep there. And this was the place where his house was. So, what a strange place for a... Yeah, it was a farm, okay. So all this land was from him. Hello, spirits. I do. You know, I'm going now. You can see the place where the farm was from the serial killer. And this is the place where I find the strange dolls. I don't know what to do with it. Well, there's enough time for a new video. But you know, I go, there's nothing more to see than this. So it's a little bit boring. Spirits, talk to me. Okay.
Viewer discretion is advised.
Willem van Eyck was born in 1941. In the small village of Kortraar in South Holland. During his time at an elementary school in Ter Aar, he was an outcast and referred to as Gekke Willempje, that's crazy little William, something he later used to justify his action. During this time of extreme bullying, Willem started to collect morbid items, such as dead bugs and frogs. He soon gained notoriety in his home village for his cruelty towards animals.
especially dogs, cats and ducks. Still a loner when attending high school, Van Eyck committed petty crimes. During this time, he started to dream about raping and killing women. The first victim was Cora Mantel. It was in 1971. He picked up the 15-year-old Cora Mantel from Uithoorn, having missing a bus ride home after meeting with her boyfriend in Amsterdam. Van Eyck found her hitchhiking. He raped and strangled her with her own shawl before dumping her body in a ditch near Uithoorn. Her body was found on 22 June in 1971. Because on the morning of the murder, she was to start a new job at a jewelry store in Alsmeer. The jewel was for a short period of time a suspect. Altje van der Plaat was the second victim. On 19 August 1970, the lifeless body of the 43-year-old Altje van der Plaat was found near a road inside a cornfield. She was a nurse. She had suffered multiple stab wounds, her belly was ripped open and the left nipple was cut off. Willem van Eyck lived in a houseboat named De Vrijheid, The Freedom, at the end of the road. Several witnesses had seen Van Eyck ride his moped on the evening the body was found, near the area where the body was found. Okay. Police arrested Van Eyck and he immediately confessed to the murders of Cora and Altje in 1975. Van Eyck was sentenced to 18 years imprisonment and TBS. The details of the murders, as revealed during the trial, were so horrifying that several Judy Carrier guards vomited. Psychiatric reports explain that Van Eyck has several childhood trauma as a result of bullying and reaction by women. During this therapy at the Van Mestag Kliniek in Groningen, psychiatrists speculate that his defiant behavior was the result of brain damage sustained during his birth. In 1980, while still in remand, he married his pen friend Adrie. In 1990, he was released and together they moved into a house in Harkstede. That was a farm. Psychiatrists believe that this relationship with Audrey would prevent him from reoffending, but warns that subsequent female reactions could trigger a relapse. The relationship turned out to be a downward spiral for Van Eyck and Antoinette Bertalda, Michelle Fatol, were killed in November 1993. And in a ditch near the Vellus Ene Mathilde, the corpse of this 23-year-old prostitute was found. It turned out to be Michelle Fatol. During sex with Van Eyck, Van Eyck strangled her with his bare hands. Annelies Reines, on 21 January 1995, the body of the 31-year-old prostitute Annelies Reines was found in the Eemskanaal near Appingedam. Between his release and his second arrest, there were 8 prostitutes and several other young women murdered in the area and around the area of Van Eyck's residence. In 1997, Van Eyck was a suspect for the murders of Anna de Ruiter de Weld and in 2000 for the murder of Marianne Vaatstra. However, DNA tests proved his innocence of these cases. Several years later, murderers of these two women were caught. Sascha Schenker, on 17 July 2001, the lifeless naked body of the 34-year-old prostitute Sascha Schenker was found in the Slochterdiep near Harkstede.
Her clothes were found several months later near Van Eyck's house. They were found to have been thrown into the canal in a plastic bag weighted with stones. Because Schenker's clothes were found near Van Eyck's house, he became a prime suspect, and on 12 November 2001, police arrested Van Eyck. He soon confessed to the murders of Michel Fatol, Annelies Reinders and Sascha Schenkers. Police also suspected him of the murders of Shirley Herreigers, Antoinette Bond and Jolanda Meyer. However, Van Eyck did not confess to those, and they were not concrete evidence for his involvement. The ground around his house was excavated, and however, there were no bodies found. As of 2013, Jolanda Meyer is still missing. And the possible victims? Between 1993 and 2001, several other bodies were found, and in 1995, the torso of the 24-year-old prostitute Antoinette Bond was found in the Winschoten Diep. Other body parts were later found in a sport bag. And 2 years later, in 1997, the body of the 90-year-old prostitute Shirley Herreigers was found. Around the same time, Jolanda Meyer, from 35, Herreigers' friend and colleague, also disappeared, and several other men were suspected of the killings, but all turned out to be innocent. Willem van Eyck never confessed to kill these women, however, its publicity believe he is responsible. And the trial and the sentence. At the start of the trial, van Eyck was represented by lawyer Willem Anker, much to the astonishment of the relatives of Shirley Herreigers, as Willem Anker also represented them. When Van Eyck official declared a suspect in murder Shirley, Willem Anker dropped his client. After going through a series of other lawyers, Van Eyck was sentenced on 7 November 2002 to life imprisonment for the murder of the last three victims. Hi everyone, I just filmed at the place where the house was from Willem van Eyck. I filmed there. This is just the neighborhood, is a couple of meters from his house. I'm going home now. I think I have a lot of EVPs, but I need to check it out. Hope you have a great weekend, maybe holiday already. I'm Mariam from Wildy's Paranormal Place. Well, that was excited. Yeah. No house, but you know the feeling where he lived. Yeah? He walks there, he do everything there, and why? Why he did that? I can't believe something that you can do something like this. Kill women because you think you need to do it. It was so stupid. It's a really messed up mind. And then 1,000 miles. I don't know, but this is Groningen, no city in Holland. We're not Amsterdam, but you know, we have mass murderers here, and there are more. But you know, this one is, yeah, it's closest at my home. Okay, well. Peace. This is deel 4. As you can see, there's a way, and so all this here.
Fiets naar het westen richting de hoofdweg.
Okay.